Hi everyone, my name is Yu Yang Li. I finished the final project by myself. Today I will introduce a famous artist, Suzanne Valadon, who is a great reformer to challenge the traditional male gaze by using the female nude body. I will use course reading to how the artist depicts natural womanhood, not from the male gaze. There are six parts to my presentation. Firstly, I will introduce the background of Suzanne Valadon, including her family and life experience. And then I will summarize her professional achievements. As we know, Suzanne Valadon develops female nude art as a subject to show confidence, freedom, and new femininity. But there are still some styles of her artwork according to display major artwork. I will introduce the main ideas of her creation and how she contributed to showing natural womanhood from the female gaze instead of the male gaze. Last but not least, I will explain how her artwork reflects gender issues and social problems based on images. Now let's look at the first part, background of Suzanne Valadon. Valadon is a French painter, printmaker, and model who was born in 1938 and died in Paris. Born in poor family, Valadon never knew her father in her childhood. She was very represent. Transgressive. She was very aggressive, which inspired her to be a positive person as she grew up. When she was 5 years old, her mother took her to Paris and lived with Valadon's art. In order to escape the stigma of being an enslaved mother, under the political unrest, they finally moved to Montmartre, where it was full of artists, prostitutes, and other unusual characters. I think the living environment impact Valadon to focus on women, particularly female nude art, in her future creation, because she once recalled this period as her happiest life, that there were excitement, love, and ideas around the street. In her new home, Valadon kept her aggressive characters like a boy. She was stubborn, independent, hot, and sensitive, charming, and full of energy. She has a vivid imagination and seldom considers logic when she tells stories to others. Valadon demonstrated an avowed interest in art when she was young. At the age of 15, she became an artist. Unfortunately, she fell from the tramway and injured her back during a performance. This accident ended her career, but gave her time to immerse herself in the art world. From 1880s to 1893, she modeled for several painters, including Renoir and Toulouse Lautrec, and learned art knowledge from those artists. Her best friend, Ego Dargos, was her mentor to teach her drawing and etching techniques. By 1909, she married Mario Autry and then discovered at the age of 44. Since then, she started painting all over the day and held her first solo exhibition after 2 years. Baladon's professional achievement can be divided into two periods, the early period and the metro period. She gained a well-known reputation in the 1920s and held four major retrospective examinations during her lifetime. Compared with other female artists who use a male name to sell their artwork, Baladon gained respect from the male guests and provided an insightful exploration of human experience, especially working class women. Baladon is a post-impression and famous artist. Her article style focuses on nude subjects, especially self-portraits with unidealized depiction. Based on her own experience as a model, she depicts a nude female figure with a strong line and quality to show natural womanhood, not from the male gaze. Baladon focuses on female nude body to challenge traditional views about sex and the beauty of women. In her paintings, nude figures are depicted as working class women without many decoration. The purpose of nude subject is not to emphasize sex. Instead, it shows unlimited freedom for women. Like the two works created by Baladon, she depicts the sense of bathing where her mother and grandmother are waiting beside the young girl. It shows a gentle and warm care of the womanhood. Arthur Chadwick said in chapter 10, Baladon rejects the static and timeless presentation of the monumental nudes that demanded Western art, but emphasized context, specific movement, and physically action in isolate from the male guest. Both images emphasize the artwork of a figure in control of their own movement. The joy of life depicts the sense of bathing in natural or nude in landscape. Inspired by ancient Greek landscape painting, the difference is that Baladon includes a male but put him to the side. This is not a painting about fantasy, but about the physically yearning for sexual connective experienced by both men and women. It seems that those female figures and natural create harmony, but they are isolated from the male spectre. Baladon is an aggressive female artist because she depicts female nude body isolated from the male gaze. During the period, showing femininity from a female gaze is a brave creation to challenge the traditional view. Through those paintings, it makes artists focus on new femininity and self-love for women. We can feel the femininity and motherhood from the sun of bathing and show natural womanhood and sex freedom from the models, which case a social campaign about women's rights by feminist artists. Like another important work, Nude Arranging Her Hair, painted in 1916. Baladon painted a nude at her toilet, but she depicts a burly and strong woman, which is opposite to the idealized female nude from a male perspective. Baladon didn't emphasize sexual desire. Intersectionality emphasizes the close connection between art, gender, and society. As a female artist, Van Damme made great contribution to promoting new femininity and natural womanhood through nude subject, which inspired other female artists to depict women from their perspective. Not least for male artists, besides, female nude subject also show the confidence of working class women and the reality inside. Without sexual desire, it reflects Van Damme's opinion that art should have no sex. The typical artwork, The Blue Room, doesn't depict a nude body, but it challenges the traditional view of gender roles. Van Damme portrays herself as a working class woman who is smoking in bed. The painting the leisure state of Van Damme, but also emphasizes the action of smoking, which should be a male activity. Therefore, the painting reflects her effort to promote female freedom. The brief ideas bring a big shock for male artists. This is my presentation about Van Damme. I hope you can learn something about the artist's experience and contribution to women's freedom and female womanhood. Thank you very much.